Hi everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial, I will show you how to bind data to the React HeatMap Chart component. I will explain how to bind two-dimensional array and JSON data to the React HeatMap Chart component using cell binding and row binding methods. I will open an existing React application where I have bound the heatmap component to an array of data using the row binding method. In the row binding method, each object in the array renders as a column in the heatmap chart component. To see how to get started with the heatmap chart and bind array data using the row binding method, refer to the video linked in the card above. I will run this application using the command npm start to show the initial demo. Look at the heatmap chart component rendered with the defined data source. You can see that each object in the array renders as a column here. However, in the cell binding method, you can set the position of data points by defining the x-axis and y-axis values. Let's see how to bind the array data using the cell binding method. To start, I modify the heatmap data object value with two-dimensional array objects. Here, each object in the array represents the x-axis, y-axis, and the data point. For example, here 0 represents the position of x-axis, 1 represents the position of the y-axis, and 14.5 represents the data point value. Similarly, each object represents a data point in the heatmap chart. I modify the string array's x labels and y labels based on the data source values. These arrays store the collection of axis labels to be displayed on the axes. To configure the heatmap chart with two-dimensional array objects using cell data binding, I need to use the data adapter. For that, I import the adapter module from the EJ2 React heatmap package. Then inject it into the services. I add the data source settings property and set the adapter type property as cell. As you know, I have bound the two-dimensional array object data source, so I set the isJSonData property to false. See the heat map chart rendered using the cell binding method. Here the data point 14.5 corresponds to the cell, which represents the x-axis value of 0 and y-axis value of 1. Next, I will show how to bind JSON data to the heatmap chart using the cell binding method. Let me modify the current array object value with the fields row ID, column ID, and value. Here each object represents each cell in the heatmap chart. Row ID represents the position of the x-axis, column ID represents the position of the y-axis, and value represents the appropriate data point value. I modify the string array's x labels and y labels based on the data source values. I set isJSonData to true. Next, I need to map the data source fields row ID, column ID, and value to the heatmap chart component. Inside the data source settings property, I add the x data mapping property and map the row ID field to it. Similarly, I map the column ID field to the y data mapping property and the value field to the value mapping property. Look here, the heat map chart is rendered with the defined JSON cell data. In this example, look at this data point 77.6, which is plotted on the heat map chart with the x-axis value France and the y-axis value 2010. Finally, I will show you how to bind JSON data to the heat map chart component using the row binding method. I modify the heat map data value with the region field. Then I modify the x-axis label and y-axis label with appropriate values based on the data source. After that, I change the adapter type to table and map the field region to the x-axis by setting it to the x-data mapping property. The other fields will be automatically mapped to the y-axis and data point values respectively. Checking now, the heat map chart is rendered with the JSON data using the row binding method. Notice here, the data point 93 lies on the heat map chart, where the x-axis represents the region USA, and the y-axis represents the year 2000. In this video, you have seen how to bind an array and JSON data to the heatmap chart component using the cell binding and row binding methods. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.